Hey everyone, this is Tim. I want to show off the system I put together for the pieces, and then I got the tape deck I was looking for. As you might have noticed in my past videos, I used to have a couple of these main pieces here on the bottom of the floor. That's how I was recording them. I knew it wasn't good to keep the equipment on the floor. My girlfriend mentioned it, and obviously I want to get rid of it eventually. But I didn't want to have one of the speakers on the floor either at first, but I thought that was, you know, a pretty big deal. I wanted to have that gooder, better surround sound. And the room I'm in is really kind of small. It's not that big. I'm just spending time here in my family's home until I get my own apartment, since I'm just trying to move up in my jobs. So, as you can see, I had a speaker on each side of the bed in one of these main tables with the lamp. I got rid of the lamp over here to make room, push this into the corner area right here, put my speaker down below, and it really is a great speaker sound system anyway, so it doesn't make that much difference if it's down low or a little bit or up high on the other side. So now these are the pieces we have. I'll give you some backup on that. Actually, first of all, let me show you these. These are Advent speakers. So let me know if anyone knows them. That's the height of them. If you see the size of the see the size of the record sleeve right there. Not too much higher. Another half a record sleeve's width. These are great sound. I picked up from a guy in Charlotte who has a store. His name is the Speaker Doctor. This older guy, and the whole room is just basically full of, you know, some really cool things he's always fixing up, and speakers and amps and things he's selling. I'd recommend highly going there if you're in Charlotte and you're looking for a good pair of speakers. Blake might be aware of the place I'm talking about. Now, if you check this out, this is my setup right here. I have the Sony Audio Video Control Center. Now, this has the DBFB, Dynamic Bass Sound is what it says. Has all the bass, treble, and balance, and the usual stuff. These things right down here, I usually always have on there, the DBFB and the surround, so it's pretty good to have. Yeah, I don't know too much about all this information in terms of models and stuff. I just wanted to show the piece and, you know, have a little bit of four to five different, you know, companies right here that I'm using. So we have Advent speakers, Sony receiver. Now, when I got it, when I first got my record player, I realized, okay, I need to find the receiver now. I went to a couple pawn shops, went to Salvation Army, and the pawn shop had this receiver for $60, but then I went to Salvation Army, and they were selling this receiver for $50. The receiver came with the CD player and a pair of speakers. I didn't need the speakers or the CD player, so I was like, hey, listen, can I just buy the receiver from you? But they only sold it in the pair. But it was still cheaper, $10 cheaper than the pawn shop, just to get all of them. So now I have an extra pair of speakers in the closet. I got this receiver right here. I didn't really think about the time, about the CD player, because I really just wanted a record player, but then I hooked it up and it made sense, because then I was like, why don't I just have, I have a bunch of CDs, so why don't I just have a whole sound system going? So the CD player right here is a JVC. I don't really even know all this stuff means down here, but I can read it to you. PEM-DD converter, public edge, modulation, differential, linearity, errorless DA converter. I don't know all that stuff means, but if you see, it's really funny. It's a really big open-close button. So this is just a random CD of mine, just to give you an idea what you're listening to. Kendrick Lamar. Overly dedicated. Kendrick Lamar is the frickin' man. So let's see how these sounds on here. Just so you guys have an idea. It's a cool little intro I forgot on the CD that's good to cool to play on the speakers.
I'll tell you what I don't believe in. Can I do that? Alright, I don't believe in the laws or the system by any means.
Have this on number three for the sound.
I try not to obey them at any time. That's what I believe in, not believing in.
So what keeps you alive?
Four big bottles of water a day, two packs of Marlboro Reds, and what keeps me alive? Shit. Music. I can't have to listen to music all day long.
Just you guys have an idea of my room size.
I'm pretty sure personally. I thought about ending it a million times, and I have to say that music keeps me here. By far the main thing.
Thank you.
Sitting in the studio thinking about what's more we're going right now. Freestyle or write down, whatever. Yeah, so, I mean, this sounds great on these speakers. That's a CD player. This is what I got just the other day, yesterday I think it was. The brand is Techniques. I got the Techniques tape deck. This right here is a stereo double cassette deck. Basically has both sides of here. Now, I'm not as familiar with this stuff, so I'd really appreciate some help with people in terms of what I can do here. Like this right here, I know it's tape 2 is the record and playback, and tape 1 over here is playback. It says high speed dubbing, one touch recording, cue and review. Now, I'm just not sure about these things here. Like that light goes on there for tape speed, either high or normal. Dubbing and mixing on or off. And then I don't think this input level is for anything, honestly. So it is fun though. How it has like has a little digital section over here that has sound showing when it's actually being recorded and you're using it or playing something on it. If anyone knows what the input's for, maybe it's for something I don't have, let me know. Also with the tape counter. I thought tape counter was maybe so that you'd know how many minutes were remaining on your blank recording cassette tape, but I don't think that's right. So if anyone can let me know what the tape counter is for, I would really appreciate that, just because I'm newer to it. So let's go to tape. Stop this one for you. I love how great the sound from the cassette tape sounds in this. Right now we're going to be checking out on the cassette tape we got Prodigy's Fatherland. I thought Smack My Bitch Up was a great song to hear on this in terms of sound. See, has that digital right there? I like having that digital sound, little wave system over there. This bass is even lower. I don't even have the bass halfway, but it'll still have a really nice bass sound, so it's gonna kick in right now. Everyone loves this song. It's funny, some of you might be thinking of Charlie's Angels or something. Okay. So that's our Techniques tape deck player. Let me know the info you know about that stuff in the middle, like tape counter, the input level from 1 to 10, tape speed, dubbing, mixing. I know I can record stuff, which is great to have, but I'm not sure what else I can do. So I actually did just make a mixtape for my buddy last night for his birthday. Now, last thing we have here is the turntable, of course, that you guys have all seen a bunch of times. Now, tell me if you know about this. The brand of the turntable is, it says Studio Standard. It's by Fisher. Now, the Fisher on the right side is exactly the same exact writing as what I think is Fisher Price. So maybe it's the same company. You guys let me know. It's a Belt Drive DC Servo Semi-Automatic Stereo Turntable. Belt Drive DC Servo Semi-Automatic Stereo Turntable. Now, I'm new to turntables in general, so I don't know much info about them. It has their speed right here for the 45s and the 33s. I can adjust the speed on the 33 or the 45, so I can make each version slower, which is pretty cool to do because it doesn't really change the pitch of the voice that much. So you can sort of speed up and slow down. I don't do it much, but it sort of keeps it in the key, and it can actually just sound good. And then the reject button. I learned not to mess with the reject button. If you guys know about this, if you had this problem, if I actually pick this thing up, my arm, and put it over here, a lot of times when I rejected the button, reject button to move it, and then I tried to load it something else again, it wouldn't go down. Let's see if it does it now. No, it's going down. But sometimes it wouldn't go down, and it would actually just like not touch and sort of like stop itself and then go back. It denies playing the record. You guys know what that's all about, so I don't mess with the reject anymore. Also, if you guys can help me, I just have it normal. I just have it set on like 0 on this side, and then I have it set on the setting over here on 2. I have no idea what these numbers are for and what they mean. So if someone can let me know what they're all about, I would appreciate it. So we're gonna play right here. It's Mac Davis's I Believe in Music. Down there, it's one of the records I picked up the other day. You guys can see how this sounds. Oh, and also, I don't know much about cartridges, but I know some of you guys do. The cartridge that was on here, this was actually a fixed... Sorry, it's hard to see it. Can you get my focus in? It's Shure 78. I don't have know anything about the cartridges you guys talk about. You just show me the work that's done on here. Tell me if this is a nice one. I got this refurbished. Actually, I got this from Lunchbox Records in Charlotte, refurbished by this guy who does the work. So if you guys can let me know if it seems okay. It was just I know it was refurbished, but it seems in great shape. And this is the thing I was talking about. I don't know where these numbers are supposed to be at all. I just know that this thing is also actually, you know, for lifting it up and putting it down. But I just don't know how the weight is and what it's supposed to do for it. And then I have this thing that lights up here. But, again, I heard that, like, these lines and the grooves here are supposed to be perfectly set with a certain line on one of these things right here where the light matches on the grid. But I don't really understand it. I don't think I need to understand it, but I don't. So, let's try the vinyl. I'll show you how I can adjust the speed on the 33. Well, I could just sit around making music all day long. Long as I'm making music, I know I can't do nobody wrong. And who knows, maybe someday I'll come up with a song. It's nice thing to have. I don't know why people necessarily use the speed adjust button that much, but it's nice to have. As I said, it doesn't make it sound bad at all. It still sounds nice. And here's that light up I was talking about. Maybe it's supposed to be on that second line. I'm not sure. I wish if I knew if there's a way to play mine backwards, that'd be fun. But yeah, this is my setup. So, hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you have any info or things I asked about, I'd appreciate the help. It'd really be nice for me. So, yeah, thanks for watching. This is my setup. And hope to talk to you guys and watch your videos more and see you guys soon. Take care.